Hello everyone, I am Dr. Sapna Prabhu. I am the head of department of electronics and computer science at FRCRC, which is popularly known as Father Agnel. As you all may be aware, FRCRC has always been committed towards quality engineering education, and with due emphasis which is done on holistic development, we as an institute believe in a great teaching learning process, as well as ensure that we offer enough avenues to all our students in the form of various co-curricular and extracurricular activities. Speaking specifically about the ECS department, I'd like to tell you that the ECS, which is Electronics and Computer Science department, is offering you a four-year degree program, a bachelor's degree program in electronics and computer science. I'd like to show you a few slides to try and elaborate on what I'm trying to do. And I hope that at the end of this small talk, your doubts and queries will be all cleared. Let me share my screen with you. Okay, so as I have been saying that we are talking about the Department of Electronics and Computer Science. First and foremost, what does ECS offer? Now, ECS offers you, as I mentioned, bachelor's degree, a four-year degree in electronics and computer science, and we are affiliated to the University of Mumbai. ECS is giving you a mix of subjects in electronics as well as computer science, which aim at equipping students with important concepts related to the field of electronics as well as computer science. So what we're trying to get at is that you're going to get a mix of subjects where, you have the key conceptual subjects of electronics and the key conceptual subjects of computer science, both integrated in the course, along with which we give you a wide variety of electives. So what you have is a wide choice of elective subjects, which you will be able to take from the third year in both the areas, electronics as well as computer science. And that will help a student to explore his or her strengths or their interests. See, let's understand this very clearly. Most students at after year 12 standard are not very clear about what exactly are their interests or where their strengths lie. So ECS, because it is giving you a mix of electronics and computer science, right till the second year, you are allowed to explore. That will allow you to identify where you find your interest or your niche area, and this and you can take your choices. So you can take electives in third year, which will basically get aligned to those interests. ECS also offers you, there's a great emphasis in ECS on hands-on learning. We always hear this, we hear this input from industry, etc., saying that the theoretical studying of an academic degree and the industry requirements do not match. There's a huge gap in it because students are not industry ready. So in the ECS curriculum, there is going to be an emphasis on hands-on learning, and that is going to involve extensive practical work, as well as we'll ensure that there will be proficiency in the programming languages that industry requires. It's an excellent opportunity for a student to have strengths in both electronics and computers, and that is going to definitely ensure good placements in top companies. You also have an option to pursue further studies, maybe a master's, M.Tech, or an M.S. in either electronics or computer science. It keeps you open to both the possible domains. Let me share with you the motivation of why we started the ECS course. The current technology trends, or the projection of the trends that you see now, they are demanding that a student or an engineer should have interdisciplinary knowledge. And therefore, we found the need to try and merge these two courses. For that matter, electronics and computer science are closely related, right? You would notice that many foreign universities, including the MIT, they offer bachelor's degrees in electronics and computer science. This is not true so much in Indian universities, but foreign universities have always been offering this kind of a degree. So taking inspiration from them and understanding their vision And agreeing with their vision, we felt that it was a need to take the step ahead and try and, you know, bridge this problem where, you know, a student only has in, knowledge in one particular area. So we thought of merging them, right? Almost all branches of engineering, if you notice, right from chemical, civil, mechanical, all have migrated towards automation. Hence, along with the traditional, you know, conceptual understanding of mechanical systems or chemical processes, etc., integrating software into these systems has now become a necessity. Therefore, I don't think they can, you can have any engineer who does not understand programming or doesn't have programming skills. So therefore, we realize that it's important that we can now, we can safely now merge two possible branches. The ECS course has been designed not just by academicians. We've taken major inputs from industry because, as I told you, we were trying to address the gap. There were major inputs taken from industry personnel so that the curriculum becomes relevant and will be able to create employable engineers who will meet the requirements of Industry 4.0. So this is the degree which is done with a slightly futuristic view. If you look at the ECS curriculum, the scheme of which is already available on your website, I would suggest that you go and check it out. You will notice these are some of the major subjects that we cover in the ECS curriculum. They range from artificial intelligence to the IoT, which is Internet of Things, to robotics, to cloud computing, to blockchain, to big data, to cybersecurity, to quantum computing, mobile communication, to name a few. So obviously you'll have basic subjects, but these are the subjects that you would be also studying in the four-year curriculum. I'd like to also highlight slightly about what detailing has been done for an ECS syllabus. For example, a student, if you look at the syllabus, you will notice that a student will be able to, you know, do a compulsory course, let's say in artificial intelligence, and will in the subsequent semester be able to take an elective in, say, machine learning. And probably in this next semester after that, we'll be able to, you know, build on that by taking a course in deep learning. So essentially, these three subjects will actually pave the path for a student's grip on the area of AI, ML, etc. So these three. So the syllabus has been made keeping into mind the continuity. Similarly, another vertical that we can talk about is microcontrollers. The student can study embedded systems in the semester next after that, and after which you can top it up with IoT, which is Internet of Things. So the sequencing has been done to create expertise in the area of IoT, right? I would like to speak about this because, see, IoT again is another such area which is interdisciplinary. Somebody who wants to try and design something, a thing, Internet of Things. So if you want to design a thing, it's essential to understand the design of the device and then how to extract data from that device and put it up onto the net. So you would require information of electronics as well as of, say, cloud computing, as well as, say, data analysis and so on. So it's a classic case of how industry is now coming up with applications which are actually across various domains. And hence the relevance of a course like ECS. Another area, as I've been mentioning in the slide, is, you know, you could probably, a student can realize when they are in the second year that probably they're excited towards robotics. And to learn robotics or to understand or try and gain an expertise in robotics, you know, a pre-course like industrial automation with something like controls and instrumentation earlier will help. So the curriculum has been very carefully designed to ensure that you have verticals, and you as a student have an option after third year to choose your area depending on your interests and your strengths. Having said that, if you choose a particular vertical, it's not true that you cannot switch to something else. It's not true, right? So you have that option also with you. So it's an extremely flexible curriculum, and it is meant to give a student a great grip on both the areas of electronics as well as computer science. I have been asked this question quite often, and I would like to, you know, mention it right here. One of the most frequently asked questions about ECS is, you know, how much of the curriculum is electronics and how much of it is computer science? Well, let me tell you this. It depends on how a student chooses third year subjects. So if a student is aligned towards or is inclined towards, say, a computer science, then I could safely say that a student who graduates after 4 years could end up doing, say, 65 to 70% of computer science subjects and the remaining 30-35% of electronic subjects. While vice versa, if a student is more aligned or inclined towards electronics, you could just have the reverse case. So the proportion of subjects will clearly depend upon the elective choice. And we here at the department are there to advise. And we've got experienced faculty who will help you to make these choices for you, which will help you to guide you in making these choices. And the outcome is very clear. The outcome is the intent that everybody who graduates from ECS has found what he or she would like to do and would have created enough expertise for the same, right? So this is all I wanted to share with you, because to hope and to clarify and tell you about what this ECS curriculum is all about. And we are available, as I we put up some numbers here. So at the admission desk, you can contact us at the admission desk. And I am Dr. Sapna Prabhu. I'm the head of department, as I told you. And this is my mobile number. I welcome you to, you know, contact me at any app in case you have any kind of queries. I'll be more than happy to solve them for you. Thank you very much for your patience hearing. Bye.